1.8 million tests that you say the United States has done, the Inspector General for the Department of Health and Human Services released a report today, a survey of more than 300 hospitals across the country. And the number one complaint from those hospitals were severe shortages of testing supplies and long wait time. I mean,
it's
a
just
week
wrong.
Or longer.
And did I hear the word Inspector General? Really? It's wrong. And they'll talk to you about it. It's wrong.
But this is your own government.
Well, where did he come from, the Inspector General? What's his name?
It came from the Inspector General.
No, what's his name?
What's I don't
his
know his name.
Well,
off the find top
me
of
his name.
Head.
Let me know, okay? If you find me his name, I'd appreciate it.
But, sir, these are hospitals.
All I can tell you is this.
Sir,
we put up on the board. You're going to ask the Admiral. But
are
we are doing.
Who say that they're waiting a week or longer
fine.
To get their
speak
test
to the
results?
Admiral.
Why?
But
is
we've
it
done
still
more testing
so
and had more results than any country anywhere in the world. They're doing an incredible job. Now they're all calling us. They want our testing. What are we doing? How do you do the 5-minute test? How do you do the 15-minute test? So give me the name of the Inspector General. Could politics be entered into that?
Follow up on this question of the HHS Inspector General. And by the way, her name was Christi Grimm. And it wasn't so much her opinion, but they interviewed 323 different hospitals.
Well, it still could be her opinion. When was she appointed? When was she appointed?
I'm not sure when she was
Would
appointed.
Would you do me a favor? Let me know.
I'll check.
No, no, let me know now. I have to know now, John. Let me know now.
Well,
because we are doing an incredible job in testing. We are doing a better job than anybody in the world right now in testing. There's nobody close. And other nations admit this. Other nations have admitted it very strongly. Other nations are calling us, wanting to know about our testing. Let me know when she was appointed, would you?
But specifically,
ahead,
what
please.
She was saying
sir,
was that there had been a delay in the
Okay, thank you very much. How long has that person been in government? Could I ask you that?
Did serve in the previous administration.
Oh, you didn't tell me that. Oh, I see. You didn't tell me that, John. You didn't tell me that. Did serve in the previous administration. You mean the Obama administration. Thank you for telling me that. See, there's a typical fake news deal.
You asked
now,
me when
look,
she was appointed.
Look,
I told you when she was appointed.
You're a third
by your
rate reporter. And what you just said is a disgrace, okay? You asked me, you said, sir, just got appointed. Take a look at what you said. Now I said, when did this person, how long in government?
But,
well, it was appointed in the Obama administration. Thank you very much, John.
Sir.
Thank you very much. You will never make it.
As the president was taking these questions, Jim Acosta, he certainly was. I mean, he was going back and forth with people, but it was certainly very defensive, I think, would be a fair way to describe it.
Absolutely. I mean, this is a president who sounds, I mean, even though he's been doing these briefings day in and day out for weeks now, sounds like a president whose back is up against the wall. And what seemed to really set him off were questions about this new Inspector General's report out of the Department of Health and Human Services. That report, the name on that report was from the principal deputy inspector general there, Christi Grimm. At one point during the briefing, when he was asked about this Inspector General's report, the president said, where did he come from, this Inspector General? What's his name? Well, it's not a man, it's a woman. And just to give our viewers a sense of what's in this Inspector General's report, it essentially surveyed hospitals around the country and found critical supply shortages, not just critical supply shortages in terms of treating patients, but also protective equipment for doctors and nurses and so on, which puts everybody at risk at these hospitals. And the president was going back and forth with several reporters, essentially saying, well, you know, is this an Obama political appointee? Well, according to Mrs. Grimm's bio on the HHS website, she was appointed by the Trump administration in January of this year, and her experience goes all the way back to 1999. So she has served in government for both Democratic and Republican administrations, including the current one. And you heard the president rip into John Carl of ABC News for a moment there. That was totally uncalled for. Refer to John Carl as a third-rate reporter. I've known John for many years. He's a terrific reporter
ridiculous.
Over at ABC who has lots of experience and was asking the right questions, as were others in the room, about all of this. But it just goes back to, Aaron, what we've heard for weeks now, and that this president is just terribly sensitive when it comes to criticism of the government's response in all of this and how they've been able to manage getting these supplies out to states across the country. It has been a massive failure on the part of this federal government, and the president seems to know that and is just bristling and having outbursts anytime a question is asked about this.